What's up, y'all? Dustin Jones here with Stronger Life Fitness. Want to talk about shoes. We get lots of questions about what shoes should I wear to the gym? What shoes should I wear to work out at home? Want to give you some things to think about, mainly three special things to think about when you're picking a shoe to really start exercising. The first thing that we want to think about is the firmness of the sole. So if you look at a shoe like this, this is a Reebok Nano. This sole is rather firm. It has a little bit of give when I push into it, but not a ton. As compared to a lot of running shoes or even walking shoes, it's very squishy. It's almost like a marshmallow on your foot. That may be great for some activities, but for lifting heavy things, that's not great. You want a solid, stable platform for when you are lifting relatively heavy weight, that your feet have a solid purchase on the ground or on that sole, to where you don't feel a whole lot of movement when that sole compresses when you're lifting heavy things. So firmness of the sole is the first thing. The second thing we want to think about is the heel drop. So the heel drop is the difference between the thickness of the heel of the shoe and the thickness of the front of the shoe. And so ideally, it's different for each person, but we want to see a little bit of slope is perfectly fine. It really depends on you, your body type, and your mobility. So let's say if you have tight ankles like me, if I go to squat, I really like it when my heel is thicker than the front of my shoe, because that allows me to go a little bit deeper into the squat. If I'm doing a deadlift or picking something up off the ground, I want my shoe to be a little flatter, meaning not that much of a difference between the back and the front. The big thing that you want to think about is if you have a really tough time squatting and you can't squat that deep, put your heels on maybe a couple books or elevate them on something like a 2x4, for example. If you're able to squat a lot deeper and it feels a lot better, you may want to consider having a shoe that you know is going to be a little thicker in the back going towards the front, or you can compensate in a shoe like this that doesn't have much of a heel drop with something like an insert. So this is called a VersaLift. These are pretty old. The new ones are made of rubber, but you can find something along these lines in most drugstores, basically a heel lift that's going to make that heel a little bit thicker. So when you go to perform things like squats, like thrusters, even lunges, something along those lines where you're doing a squatting type movement, it's going to feel a whole lot better. So a lot of people at Stronger Life, they'll have shoes that don't have a lot of heel drop, and then they'll have some of these and they'll throw them in and that makes it a whole lot better. The third thing that we want to think about is the size of the toe box. So where your toes go, is that thick enough or wide enough, sorry, for your foot? You don't want your foot to be crammed in and constrained. You want your toes to be able to splay, because that's what they naturally do as you're lifting heavier things or you're running or you're walking. And so we want to have room for that. So a shoe similar to this, where you're going to see the toes are going to be relatively wider than the middle of the shoe, is going to be pretty solid. So those are three things you want to think about. If you have any questions in terms of the shoes that you have, what would be best for working out, or if you're looking to buy new shoes, feel free to comment below on this video or shoot me an email at dustin@strongerlifehq.com. I'd love to chat and give some recommendations. Thanks, y'all.